Hey there, welcome to a brand new episode of Music Express. My name is Twan, and in this week's vlog you will see my interview with Cor Fijneman about his classic Venus. Enjoy! Cor Fijneman is a Dutch DJ and producer born and raised in the city of Breda. He is known for both his productions, remixes and DJ sets. He also mixed several CD compilations. Trance fans will most likely remember his two editions of the famous In Trance We Trust series. Cor already played at many major festivals such as Tomorrowland, Dance Valley, Trance Energy, Mysteryland, The Love Parade, Inner City and many others. In the year 2003, Cor teamed up with singer-songwriter Jen Johnston. Their track Venus, Meant to Be Your Lover, became the official theme song for the very first ever Tiësto in Concert show in May 2003. It even got released with a massive remix by Tiësto. For this week's vlog, I sat down with Cor in his hometown Breda to ask him about the story behind Venus. My first question to him was how old he was when he started to get interested in dance music.
Dance music, it must be around when I was 12, 13, the Turn Up the Bass compilations came out back then. And it was really weird music, but I was also interested in electronic music back then. So Jean-Michel Jarre, Vangelis, I was already listening to that kind of music. But then this, like dance music came around and I was really interested in it. And my friends on the, in school said, what is this for a weird kind of music? They are not singing, it's only instrumental. I was really like, yeah, but this is the future, this is it. But that was the moment I really was interested in dance music.
Okay, and when did you start producing music yourself?
When I was around 14, my mom worked for a TV show. They got children from Chernobyl here in Holland. And my mother is Russian, so she was a volunteer for that. And she came in contact with the wife of Hans Vermeulen. He's a famous artist in the Netherlands. And once I was at this at a birthday party, and his sons were working in the home studio, and I was really focused on what these guys were doing. And at the end of the night, one of the sons said to his father, maybe we could give him a keyboard. And he was like, yeah, do it. So they gave me a synthesizer.
Oh, wow.
And I really wanted to play music, so I got piano lessons, but also had a computer. So I read in some articles, you can connect it to your computer and then program some real music. So that's why I started to make music, and later on you can, I was trying to do some dance music, got some I remixed a song by Tiësto, famous guy here from Breda. And that was the start of my musical career.
Yeah, what was that, your first release ever?
No, it was really bad. And the guys said okay, you can't release this, the quality's too low. But one day Tiësto asked me come in my studio so maybe we can do a track together. And that was Hammock Brothers Earth, that was the first one.
Okay, oh cool. So your first release was a call-up with Tiësto.
Yeah.
Not bad.
No, not bad to start.
So in 2003 your track Venus, Meant to Be Your Lover came out, which was a call-up together with singer-songwriter Jen Johnston. Was it already the plan from the start to make Venus a vocal track?
Well, it was really strange how that track became together, because I was working in the studio back then, the Black Hole Recordings studio, and she came at the office that day because I think she was working on some tracks with Tiësto. And she came in the studio, hello, I'm Cor, hello, I'm Jen. And I was working on a chord progression, and she was like, oh, what's this? Oh, this is really good. Can you give me the chord progression? I was like, okay, here you go. And then she wrote a lyrics on top of it. And that night, I think they recorded it in the studio owned by Tiësto, which was yeah, not the Black Hole studio, but a different studio. And there the vocals were already made, and then the track was built around it.
Okay. So for the instrumental version, where did the inspiration come from?
Well, there was no in the beginning there was no instrumental version. It was nothing. So that's maybe we can go on further, because the remix by Chesto was the first thing that came, and then I had to make my own version.
So the remix was done before the original.
The original.
That's cool. So this was also the very first time you guys met, right?
Yeah, it was the very first time, yeah.
And the second time?
Second time, to pick her up for the Chesterton concert. The big Chesterton concert. She had to perform there, also the Venus, because it was the soundtrack of that concert. I went to Schiphol and I was waiting for her and waiting and waiting, and I was like, she's not coming, what's going on? But then I looked again on the paper I had with me and I was like, oh no, it's tomorrow.
So you were one day early?
One day early, so the day after, again to Schiphol, and then we met again.
So is there still something you can tell about the production process of the track?
I came at the office and the guys were like, oh, you did really well, you had a Chesto remix of your track. And I was like, Chesto remix of my track? Which track? I don't know anything about it. And they were like, okay, here, Venus, with Jen Johnson, also a very good singer. And I was like, what is this? So then they said, like, now you have to do your own version. And back then I was already thinking about working together with someone, because I had very little time for and producing and traveling with and DJing. I was already DJing a lot back then, so I was searching for someone that can do something together, like an engineer. So that was the really first time we did something together. Mm-hmm. So that was the first time we made a remix.
Okay, cool. So how long did it take you to finish the track?
It was very quick, I think within a week.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you already mentioned the Tiesto remix of the song. That version of Venus was also used as a theme song for the very first Tiesto in concert in May 2003. So I guess that gave the track a huge boost as well.
Yeah, sure. That was the main remix. My remix was also nice, but that was the main thing. And immediately there was a kind of buzz. End of 2012 it was finished, so he already played it at Inner City that year, the end of the year, and I'm at the Miami Winter Music Conference. It was picked up by Judge Jules, played it on BBC Radio 1, and then it really became big. And also I got lots of gigs in England. So that was like the big boom for my career.
Yeah, and also like in the Netherlands, it became pretty big. It became a dance smash at Radio 538. It also made it into the Dutch charts. And there was even a video clip, but you're not in that video at all.
No.
How come?
No, there was one. It was also recorded at the Chesterton concert, but it was really cheesy. They put me in a really weird way. So I was immediately when I saw it, like skip my parts.
Yeah. Not gonna happen.
No.
So what is your favorite memory when it comes to the release of Venus?
It was, I think, the 2012 Inner City. Chesto played there. The track was finished the end of November, and Inner City was always somewhere around December. And I was there in the audience, and I wasn't expecting him to play it because he was really pounding it. It was like a more kind of a techno set than that was a trance set. But at the end, I suddenly hear these acid line in the beginning. And I was like, whoa, he's going to play it, whoa. And the reaction was so good. People were enjoying, and that was a really good moment.
Yeah, I bet. So you already said like Venus that gave your career a huge boost as well.
Yeah, it was from then It went crazy. I played all around the world. Only it wasn't released yet. I got a message from a booking agency in England, and when I came there, they were like, "Okay, do you want to sign with us? We already arranged these days in England, and we also have 3 days in Amnesia for you." And I was like, "What's this? Yeah. I don't know. Come on, let's do it." And at the end of the year, I was already in the DJ Mag Top 100. So. Also very unexpected.
Yeah, must have been an unreal feeling as well. So, of course we're in the middle of a pandemic right now, but besides that, do you actually still DJ a lot?
Yeah, I play a lot. Before that, it was most Friday, Saturday that I still play, and it's different music, and I do housey sets, but I also do like all round sets, but also once in a while trance classic sets, also techno sets. I do a lot.
Speaking of DJing, you were the resident in Club Spock here in Breda, a very famous venue where Tiesto also was one of the resident DJs. Can you tell us something more about that time?
It was also around the time that I started producing together with Tiesto, that he asked, I'm quitting playing at Spock, maybe it's something for you. I was like, yeah, sure. And it was a really nice time because it was... that place, it has something iconic to it, but if you look at it, it's a really small venue, and it's a part of a three-room venue, so you really have to work to keep those people in, because we play there not that really commercial music, so it was really easy for them to go to another room where they play top 40 music, and we really learned there how to play and work a crowd. So that was really nice time to learn learn DJing.
How long did you DJ there?
I think for about 5 years every Saturday and sometimes also a Friday, so it was a nice time.
So is that also where you met Tiesto?
I saw him playing there because we went there, but meeting him was more in the record stores where there was one record store in Breda, and every DJ or everyone who collected records came there and saw each other.
So you also did work there in the Magic Store?
No, it was where I'm talking about is it's the Tunesville, that was the first record store, and after that they opened also the Magic Record Store. And then with there I also got a job collecting all the records for myself.
And I get a nice discount.
It's crazy. You got a release that you wanted to keep for yourself, so you bought them all.
so no one else could play it. I heard stories like that before. Actually pretty cool. Breda actually has a very active DJ and producer scene. Besides yourself and Tiesto, there are people such as Hardwell, Rehab, Funkerman, Danik, Wacht from W&W, Mike Sixma, DJ Dazzle, Paul Moelands aka Relocate. They're all born here in Breda. Why do you think that Breda has so many talented people that play an important role in the Dutch dance scene?
Well, I think because, especially for DJing, Breda, if you know it, all the bars and clubs are really close to each other. So if you don't play good as a DJ, then people will leave because they don't have to travel a lot of time to go to another bar. They can go everywhere. So that's, I think, why DJs are really keen to play really good, and maybe it's something in the water.
are you also still active with producing these days?
And especially now,
you have a lot of time.
I have a lot of time, and I made a lot of music, so definitely something will come out.
Okay. And is it like trancey or more techno or both?
I'm doing more techno kind of stuff, but it's still melodic. But I also do some new disco stuff nowadays. And I'm trying to do some trance tracks again.
And the techno and the new disco, is that also under your own name or you have a different project
name? Well, I have different project names all of my career already. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of aliases. But what I'm focusing now is Cor Feineman still, and Fine Event, it's more the new disco thing. Yeah.
So, what kind of music do you listen to in your spare time?
Everything. If you see my Spotify, it's really weird what I listen to. It's from country, like old stuff, new stuff. I check everything. I like music, and yeah. I don't categorize music as like bad music. This isn't this can't. I enjoy different kind of music. Mm-hmm.
And the last question, pineapple on pizza, yes or no?
How dare you to ask that? No way, no way.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time and good luck with everything.
Thanks.
Alright, that was it, this week's vlog. My interview with Cor Feineman about his classic Venus. Cor, thank you very much for your time, much appreciated. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed the vlog. If you did, make sure to give this video a like, leave a comment in the comment section below, and make sure to subscribe. Once again, thanks for watching, and until next time, bye bye.